Ashley Easter.
And I'm Charlie Grantham, and you're listening to Serendipity,
the podcast where we explore everyday magic all around us.
And welcome back to the Serendipity Podcast. Ashley and Charlie are here.
Woo. Woo. And Daisy and Frankie are here in the background. Yes.
You know, I think they're maybe going to start making more cameos because they actually were good guests when we were like together in your apartment. I don't know.
That's
maybe
true. They had some strong reactions to what we were saying.
We should maybe just do an episode about them because they have such interesting personalities.
We honestly should. Yeah. Like, we should guess their, like, I don't know, like, their human design or something like
that. Yes, that would be so interesting. Do you have, like, their birth times and stuff?
No, I don't. But maybe we could, like, guess it. Like, maybe we, you know.
Use, like, the pendulum? Yeah.
Right, yeah. Like, or something else. I don't know. Like, because Frankie and Daisy's, or no, Frankie and Winston's birthdays are kind of, like, made up because we adopted them from the street.
Got it.
And then Daisy, I know her day, but I don't know the time she was born.
Got it. Okay, cool. Well, I'm excited because we haven't seen each other since I was in town. And you have a serendipitous story to share. I have not heard it yet. And I'm just like, okay, I need some more Charlie stories because I've been missing them. So what is your serendipitous story this week?
Okay, I don't think I've ever told you this, and I totally forgot that this like would be a serendipitous story. It happened almost 10 years ago.
Oh my gosh.
So this is like an old story, but it's in the top five like best days of my entire life. Ooh. Like top five favorite memories. It's like I cannot stop smiling because it just, I love this story. So I don't think you've heard it, and I have really good pictures and videos to go with this that I can share on our Instagram. So okay, so let me give some background first. So when I was around like 11 years old, I discovered this band. Oh, I didn't discover them. Like they discovered me. No, but like this band called Boys Like Girls, which is kind of like a funny name, but they were, I don't know if they're still together, but they were this band. I think I had heard their song, The Great Escape, which was like their first single, which a lot of people probably do know that song because it was pretty popular the year it came out, which was like 2007 or I think maybe 8, maybe 6. I don't know. But I just like, I heard on the radio and I was like, oh my gosh, like I love this song. And then I looked up the band. I became like absolutely obsessed. Like they became like my favorite band. I talked about them all the time. Like anybody who knew me, like my mom, my dad, like everybody knew like the ins and outs of like the band and the lives of the band members because I was like obsessed. And I had like the biggest crush on like the lead singer of the band. Like I was actually obsessed. I was homeschooled at the time, so I was like, I need something to do with my time.
Yeah.
And this
and
is
somebody to have a crush on since you're not
right. Right. So I was like totally obsessed. He was like 10 years older than me. But anyway, I was like 11 and he was like, or maybe he was more than 10 years, but anyway, he was in his 20s. So when I was like 12, I think they came to Louisiana. And so I got to go see them in concert and, I was so excited. And whenever they came out, they were like, oh, the lead singer's not here tonight. And they performed without the lead singer. And I was like, first of all, crushed because I was like, this is who I came to see. Second of all, I was like, what's going on? Like, where is he? And this is how like obsessed I was, that I was like so deep in the internet and I knew like everything about this band that I knew their tour manager's like name. Like, and I saw him and I was like, hey, like Brent, like I knew him or something. Like I'm like 12. I'm like a kid. I'm like, where's like the lead singer? And he was just like, oh, he's like in the hospital. He was dehydrated. And I was like, oh, like I was very concerned, also disappointed, but he ended up being fine.
Yeah.
So fast forward, I think they came back one other time to New Orleans, but it was like to like an 18 and older show. So I couldn't go. It was like probably 14 or 15. And then I had never seen them again. And I still just like loved them, like obsessed with them. Well, for my almost like the exact day of my 17th birthday, it was October 1st and my birthday was October 3rd. They came to New Orleans and it was like, this is what I've been waiting for like my whole life. Like I was so excited. And so Emily, which is one of my best friends, you've met Emily. Yeah. She's been on many episodes or have sent in a lot of stories. She's on in our sustainable fashion episode. You should go check that out. Well, anyway, Emily also loved Boys Like Girls. And so we went, and Emily and I went to a lot of concerts together when we were kids. And we like, of course, didn't want to like go with our parents because like, that's not cool. You know, like, I mean, now I would love to go with my parents, but as like a 15-year-old, I'm like, no, like, so the way we got around that, because obviously they're not going to let us go like by ourselves. Emily is like a family friend's daughter was like 21, and she actually had become our chaperone that would take us, but she was so cool because she was like 21 and like, you know, she's just really cool. And so that's how they let us go. So it was me, Emily, and our chaperone, Jana. I say chaperone, but she was like our friend.
Yeah, shout out Jana. If you're listening,
let us know. I should send her those. I haven't talked to her in so long. So we bought tickets and we went, and it was in the Mahalia Jackson Theater in New Orleans. If anybody is familiar with that. So we had bought tickets that were like pretty far back, like they were on the floor, but our seats were like row J, I think. So like, I think the first row's A, and then that's how far back we were. And I believe it was like a sold out show. And this is where it kind of gets like a little serendipitous. So it was a sold out show. Like, I already was anticipating it being like the best night of my life because, you know, I was just excited, but it was like literally like one of the best nights ever. So we're sitting in our seats and we're like, these are kind of far back. And it's like, Jana noticed up like on like the second row or the third row. I think it was the third. She was like, there's three seats up there that are empty. Like everything else is full, but there's three seats up there that are empty. Like, let's watch those. And when the opening act started, those seats looked like they were still open. So Jana's like, let's go take these seats. Like, those people like didn't show up, like, you know? And so we were like, okay, cool. So we go up and we get those three seats, and now we're like right up close. I mean, like, you could see like the sweat dripping off of them. Like, we're so close. And so it was like so exciting. And then like, you know, it all started, they came out, we were having a great time. I was like, I can't believe I'm like this close. Well, Boys Like Girls, actually, they sing a song with Taylor Swift called Two is Better Than One. It's a great song. Everybody should go listen to it. I think it's their most popular song, 'cause I mean, it's Taylor Swift, but, they were like, we need someone to come up and sing Taylor's part. And so we're going to, I want everyone, 'cause her part was the second verse, and they were like, who knows the lyrics to the second verse? And like, everybody just starts screaming like me or whatever. And Emily and I like, weren't really, 'cause I was like, the chances of like me getting picked, I was like, no, I'm not even gonna like, you know, do that. So I was just like, you know, whatever. And they kind of like pointed to some girl behind. He was like, be quiet. And she was like, what are the, the first line of the second verse? And she was just like kind of fumbled, and she was like, oh, I don't know. And I was like, okay, like, why raise your hand? But whatever, you know, like, that's just my and so he went to the other side and picked another girl and pointed her out, and it was like dead silent, and she just froze. She didn't say anything. And this is the moment where I don't know what came over me. Like, I have no idea. I think it's my instinct where I'm always like, oh, I'll just do it myself. Like, when someone's doing something and I'm like, let me just do it myself. Like, it's like, you know, I just started singing. He was looking at the whole other side, and I just started singing. And I remember out of my peripheral vision, like, I didn't even think, okay, start singing. And it just started coming out. And Emily just turned like slowly and was like, what the hell? And I was singing, and he looked and he was like, you come on stage. And so I got to go on stage. He was like, he gave me like instructions, and he was like, Daisy, I know it's a great story. He gave me instructions. He was like, okay, so you're going to sit here. I'm going to sing to you for the first verse and the first chorus. And then for the second verse, you'll stand up and sing. And then you'll exit like right away, and this guy over here will like help you off the stage. And I was like, got it. So I stand up, and I'm not really a singer. Okay. I think I can.
I never heard you sing.
Well, I'll send you this video. You'll hear
it. Okay.
Okay. I'm not like anyone that probably could like become like a singer, like a famous singer, but like I don't have a like unpleasant voice, like and I've had some people tell me like I have a really nice singing voice, but it's not anything I've ever like tried to like pursue or whatever. I'm just like, you know, happy singing in the shower or in the car. Well, I stand up and you'll see it in the video. I stand up and I just start singing, and you can see his face in it. He was just like, oh my God. And so then we're singing together. Like I'm singing together with like the biggest crush of my life. Like anybody I wanted, like I was like in love with him, but I also wanted to be like him. Like I thought he was so cool and smart or whatever. And he then says, stay up, keep singing with me. When I was supposed to like leave, he like told me to keep singing. So I stayed and I sang through the second chorus with him. I leave the stage. He, changes the words to the bridge. So the words are like, I remember what you wore on the first day you came into my life and I said, hey, but he like changed the words and he was like, I remember what you wore on the first day. And maybe it was Charlie who came on stage and did amazing, but like he changed and that's on video.
Oh
like,
my God.
I didn't even know he said that because I was like going down like until I rewatched the video. And then in the video, it's really funny because Jana is recording it and she kept the like camera rolling and she looks over at Emily. So now they're on the last course and Emily and I are like crying. It was so funny. And so after we met them and he was like freaking out. He was like, you did so good. I'm so impressed. He like wrote on he signed my phone case, which I still have. And it was like, never give up on your dreams. Like, you're amazing. Like, and he was like, you did such a good job. And I was just like, I was kind of just like, I think he maybe thought I wanted to be a singer and that's why he wrote that. And I was just like, oh, thanks. Like I was more of like, I can't believe I'm like talking to you. I can't believe I'm staying with you. I wasn't like thinking about how I did. And he like was like, he was like, hold on, let me get the drummer. And he got the drummer and he was like, didn't she do so good? And he was just like, no, like we have like those in ears and we can hear, like it's directly connected to the microphone. And you like did so good. You were like on perfect pitch. And like, and I was just like, oh my gosh. And so on top of that, so that's like serendipitous within serendipitous within serendipitous. Then best like night ever. Like it was just amazing. Like I called my mom. We didn't even stay for the final like band. And my mom's like, what's wrong? Why are you leaving early? And I told her they couldn't believe it. My mom and dad were like screaming on the phone. Like, so then I go home and this was like right when like Tumblr was like, I feel like starting to dimble, like dim out or whatever the word is. Yeah. And I was like on Tumblr and I think I had searched like boys like girls or something because that was like one of the things I followed, and I saw photos and I was like, this looks like the concert. And it was like this professional photographer and she just goes around and takes photos, and I was like, that's the same outfit, that looks like, this looks like, you know, and the date was the same. And I was like, so I messaged her and I was like, hey, this is random, but it looks like you were at the concert I was the one who got on stage, do you have any photos of me? She had taken like 10 professional photos of me singing on stage. So it's like so many serendipitous things. So I still have those photos. I still have, and it was just crazy because that probably wouldn't have happened if Jana hadn't seen like those three people. Like it was a sold out show, three seats. If it would have been two, it wasn't going to happen. Right. Like three seats were available. So we were able to get closer. Literally, I guess like my higher self, I don't know what came over me to start singing. That happened. And then the fact that there was a professional photographer there that she just did that for fun. She liked to go to concerts and like bring her camera.
Wow.
And I found it online by chance. Like it was just, there's so much like serendipitous like things going on. And I never thought of that as a serendipitous story, but I was like, watching the video the other day because I found it, because I thought there was a whole thing where I thought I lost the video because my computer crashed and I just found it, and I was like, wait, this is a very serendipitous story. Like I never really thought about it. So yes, it's like one of the
best. We need to get you like a manager. How come you don't have a record deal?
No, I would have liked to put
that in my bio everywhere. Like I sang with this band, and I sang in place of Taylor Swift. You should own this more.
Like, disclaimer, I'm a huge Taylor Swift fan. Like, you know, I love Taylor. That's my girl.
Her songs
are kind of easy to sing. So that is a, like, it's not like it was Beyonce. Like, you know what I mean? Like, So I think I'm really not that great of a singer. Like, I'm okay. I don't know if maybe just like other people are so nervous that they were like really off pitch or something. So it just came off, because I'm also like, I love performing. Like, I was in theater and like whatever, like at all, I've performed my whole life. So I think maybe I was used to it. Cause even in the video, you'll see like, I just, at one point I'm just like looking out in the crowd singing and he's looking at me and I'm like, what?
Who? Oh my God.
I'm always trying to channel that energy. Like, I'll watch that and I'll be like, okay, 17-year-old me. I'm like pulling that confidence like out. I'm like, it's still within me. Like, I need to like focus on like that 17-year-old Charlie energy. Cause I was like very confident.
It sounds like you were in the flow state. Do you know about the flow state?
I think you've talked about it a little, but I never thought about that.
It's like this altered state of mind that you get in, and like athletes will get it. They call it like getting in the zone kind of thing. Uh-huh. You can get into it by meditation, but like singers and speakers will often get into it. And it's like almost the whole world kind of melts away, and you just have like this confidence. And when I've studied it, it's like this combination of skill and also a challenge that you haven't met before. So you're so focused in because there is a challenge, but you also have it backed up. Like, you knew that song, you know, kind of thing. Yes. And it just kind of like feels like an out of body experience. Is that kind of like what it felt like?
That is exactly what it felt like. It really did feel like what you said, the whole world melts away. And I just did it. Like, I just did it. And it was like something else came over me. And then it was like this adrenaline. I don't even remember being nervous. Like, I just was like, this is what I'm doing. Like, it almost like I came here to do this. And I didn't even know that that was a thing they did. Like, I didn't know they called people on stage. And like I said, I wasn't even like, oh, pick me. Cause I was like, nobody's gonna pick me. Like, you know, chances. And it wasn't until, and that's why that video is kind of funny, because I seemed so confident. Like I said, I'm like looking in the audience, he's looking at me, like really confident. But once I'm back with Emily, she pans the video, like we're both like crying. I like, there's like, and Emily's smiling and singing. She's like wiping a tear away as she's singing. Oh, it's like the cutest thing ever. It's so funny. But yeah, like I think maybe like the adrenaline. And then once it had subsided and I was back with Emily, I was just like, oh my God, what did I just do? Like, I was like, did I really just do that? Like, it really was like someone else took control of my body and just like did it. And I think it is probably partially because I did a lot of performing like my whole life.
So there was like that skill and that like challenge and like just that you were so confident. I love that you also channel that part of you for confidence other times. I mean, that's amazing. I mean, you totally have to share this on our Instagram, and I don't know, maybe for the YouTube channel, you can like put it on the back end of the video or something, because people are like, I can't wait to see this.
That's a good idea. I'll put it on the back end, and then I'll put like the video and the pictures on our Instagram. Yeah. Everybody here is so like, they're so excited. Like Daisy, Frankie, Winston, they're all like screaming and barking and stuff. I'll do that. Yeah.
No, that's like one of the best stories. I can't believe I didn't know that.
I know. Oh, I can't believe I didn't tell you. I sometimes forget about it. Like, I think about it probably like 3 or 4 times a year, because it's like one of my best memories. Yeah. But yeah, I can't believe I never told you. And so when I thought about it, I was like, oh, I'm so excited because I hadn't told you and I knew you would love it.
Yes. Oh my gosh. No, that makes me so happy. And I cannot wait to see that video and the pictures. And I mean, just the fact that you were able to by chance find that photographer by accident, and that even that Jana was like videoing it, and
I know, and she kept the video going. Like, it's like a 4.5-minute video. She kept it going. I was like, I think who is, I want to like say the, oh, here it is. I wanted to say the photographer's name. Her name is Sarah Hoffman, and she, like, the chances of her listening, I mean, we never know, you know, this is everyday magic, but if she's listening, Sarah, thank you so much. It's, like, literally, like, some of my most treasured, valued possession. I have them backed up on, like, literally, like, every account possible, because, like, those photos are the best. So, shout out to Sarah.
Oh, my gosh. Oh, that's such a good story. Yeah, and, I mean, who knows? Maybe she will tune in, because we've actually had like more people leaving reviews and more people starting to listen. I was just thinking about this, but I want to pull up, we just got a new review the other day. And I was just thinking about reading it because, I'm just so excited that people are like, more people are tuning in, because we have so much fun, and I'm so glad other people are. But someone called Nutmeg502 said, their caption is like, it's 5 stars and then obsessed, exclamation point. I'm just catching up and bringing this entire episode, I think binging this entire episode. Sorry, my dyslexia is getting me. I'm going to start again. I'm just catching up and binging this entire podcast, and I am obsessed. 3 exclamation points. I feel like I need to have a 3-hour per episode conversation with you guys. Please update on the astral projection class. I'm just so happy that more people are enjoying it, because I mean, that's a great story, Charlie, and I feel like people listening, I mean, it's fun to hear, and I think it also like illustrates that anything is possible, you know? And anything is possible, and just like all your dreams can come true, and I don't know, that's just, I love that story.
And Nutmeg, you we just happened to find that review. You didn't email us with it, so if you want to email us, we will give you our like free like thank you gift of like our artwork. It has serendipity in the definition with like butterflies, and it's maybe like 4 different designs. And you can put it on your desktop, your phone, or you can print it out. So if you're listening and you would like that, definitely email or DM us on Instagram, because we'd love to give you that thank you.
Yeah. And if you want to email us, it's pod.serendipity@gmail.com. And if you want to DM us on Instagram, it's serendipity.pod.
Don't get it twisted.
And so would love that. And also, if anybody's listening and you have like cool serendipitous stories like this, I mean, I'm convinced that everybody has at least one story like that. So want to hear it. So send it to us at our Instagram. If you want to leave us a voice message, that would be amazing. If you want to take a little video of yourself telling the story, that's fine too. That would just be awesome, because it makes our day to hear other serendipitous stories.
Yes. Yes, absolutely. And I think everyone probably has more than one, and it's just about reflecting and kind of like looking for them, because I noticed I have a lot more now that, like I said, I didn't really think of that as a serendipitous story, but now that we've been like talking about it so much, and like we have our podcast, I'm like, oh, that was serendipitous. And I'm noticing, you know.
Yeah. Serendipitous, it's like law of attraction. Yes. Like the more you look at how it's happened in the past, the more things tend to come to you as well. So I don't know, I think since talking about it more, we've had even more experiences. And okay, cool. Well, thanks everybody for tuning in. This is one of our fun little mini episodes, and we'll have some full lengths for you soon, but this is so much fun. Thanks for that story, Charlie.
Yeah, thanks for listening. Bye. To figure out the rest of my life, and you already got me going.